So let's get on to the next recipe, which is caramel custard.
This is the thing I was saying earlier I felt was rather problematical. I don't know why I've always been frightened of it, but I have.
Well, it really is easy, and you can make it in about 7 minutes, something like that. First of all, let's start by making the caramel. And to begin with, the caramel, you need 3 tablespoonfuls of water and 3 tablespoonfuls of sugar. One.
Is that caster or granulated? Does it matter?
Doesn't really matter. Caster dissolves just a little bit
faster.
And there's the sugar. Now, very important at the beginning stages is to stir it, Judith. Can you come and do this? I'll just start it. Don't let it boil. I've got the plate on. Don't let it boil until it's dissolved.
All right. How do I know when it's fully dissolved?
Because it's a bit clear. You see, it's granular now.
Yeah.
Let me just turn it down just a shade. And while you're doing that, I'm going to put the milk on to get hot.
I hate this sort of responsibility. Doesn't I always feel I'm going to do terrible things to things.
And for the custard part, unlike the cold custard we had in the last recipe, it's best to start with hot milk because it begins to cook. Now, let's just have a look at that, really. Got to be clear. There we are. It is really. Now you see that's quite crystal clear. Now
that happened very quickly, didn't it?
Well, it does because I put the plate on for a moment before we started.
I see.
There we are. Now if you just boil that until it's sort of straw coloured. Meanwhile, I'll put the milk on to heat. 1 pint of milk, and 4 eggs. 4 whole eggs.
Using the same axiom that it's 2 for every half pint.
That's so right, for a set custard in the oven.
Yeah.
So in the oven we've got the custard tarts and they're set and so is caramel custard. So to begin with, 4 eggs and the sugar, 1.5 ounces of sugar. And just beat, Judith, until they're well blended. How's your caramel?
I'm having a steam treatment here.
Come to one side if it's getting in your eyes. There's nothing tricky about making caramel at all, except the basic rule, dissolve the sugar in the water first, and then boil rapidly until it's straw-coloured.
Without touching it at
Without
all, obviously, as we're doing.
If you stir it, it'll become crystallised. And if you get it dark caramel colour, you'll find that it will be a very nasty flavour.
Hot bitter.
Bitter. It may look nicer when you turn it out, but it doesn't taste so good. A lovely pale straw colour is the right colour.
I hardly dare look at you because it's getting much thicker.
Yes, it's the bubbles are dying down. Now I've beaten the 4 eggs and the 1.5 ounces of sugar. A little vanilla essence. If you wish, you can use vanilla pod and infuse it with the milk, the pint of milk. But this one I'm using just a little bit of vanilla essence. It's best to buy a good brand of vanilla essence, not a cheap one, because it doesn't taste so good. There we are.
I think it's beginning to go brown.
Yeah, it is very, just very in slightly. The very corner. Judith, can you see just over there, there's a pale strawness to it.
Yes.
Now the custard...
Just leave it on for a second.
Just leave it still and it will come in just a moment. Now, I've prepared this tin. I've just washed the tin and it's just clean. At the stage of putting the caramel in the bottom, that's all you want to do. Because you have to cook a caramel custard
there
slowly,
she blows, doesn't
well
she?
Done, you've got to cook it slowly, so I'm going to put a bath of boiling water around the outside.
Golden brown.
That's perfect.
Whip it off, shall I?
Well done, absolutely. Now pour it in there. Now it's very, very hot.
Sorry, I'm doing it the wrong way, you see. You're used to this sort of thing. Doing it the wrong
there
way.
We are. Now, this was an ungreased tin, and don't put it in a tin that isn't oven... It must be oven-proof. And run that all over the bottom until it's well and evenly coated.
I don't think I've done that very well.
I think I better put...
I think you better.
There we are. Just that little last bit in.
So it goes evenly and covers the whole area on the bottom.
That's right. It's this joint cooking. Can you put that underneath, too, if you can find a space? Run that all over the bottom, and then butter the sides. If you butter the tin before you start, you'll find... If you butter the tin before you start, you'll find that it won't be nearly as good because it will go all crystallised in the bottom. There we are. And then the milk is just hot. It should be just so you can put your finger in. I'll turn that plate off. and pour the milk in. Stirring frantically. Can you put that underneath for me too, mm-hmm. Judith? Now again, strain the custard because you will get those in a few little bits. So the caramel's at the bottom, it's well buttered around the outside, and I'm going to pour the custard in over the top. And that's it.
Lovely, thanks.
So all that needs to be done is baked now, Judith. Can you bring the kettle? It has got hot water and it's not quite boiling, but that doesn't matter. Pour water around the outside to be about halfway up the tin. The reason for doing this is so that it doesn't do too rapidly. You can do it at a very, very low oven temperature, but I find it safer to put the water around the outside.
And this is obviously enough water to keep it cooking without drying up. Is that about it?
That's just lovely. Mm. And that wants to be at 300, gas number 2, for about an hour and a half. Very, very slow, but watch it. It wants to have a pale brown on top and no bubbles in it as it's cooking, because if it boils, it will become very tough. Mm. So I'm going to put this underneath, and could you bring the one we've baked
from the fridge?
From
the fridge, yes.
And here we are. One milk bottle out of the way. Thank you, Judith. Oh, that's lovely.
Looks super. It's a lovely colour, isn't it?
Yes, now, you can cover it with foil, some recipes say. I don't. I like that nice colour on top. And you can see that in the sides, there's hardly a bubble there, and it has to be served cold. If you try and take it out of the oven, turn it out, all the caramel will be at the bottom. Now, I've done this in an oven glass dish. You can do it in a cake tin or an oven glass dish.
So just to get that straight in my head, you cook it in there in the oven, and then what? How long does it take? About 12 hours?
Well, you cook it in the oven for up to an hour and a half.
Yes, but then when you take it out?
12 hours in the fridge.
To cool, yeah. And this is one of those moments, isn't it? Oh, you're a clever lady.
There we are. Now, if you try and turn it out straight away, there'd be a thick layer of caramel. It's got to melt. So there we are, and you turn it out into a bowl like this, and then you'll get this lovely juice underneath.
Absolutely super.
Shall we have that over?
Yeah.
There we are.
Really,
and there's none left in the bottom, and it's lovely and runny, and it makes a lovely sauce. Goes well with oranges, Judith, if you have sliced oranges, or later on next month, strawberries would go well. Mm.